dear students, namaste and welcome. This is your English classroom. I'm your English teacher. Today, I'm doing a lesson from Unit 2. This is the second lesson from Unit 2. And in this lesson, we are going to read the story, three simple rules. Okay, students, we have already listened to this story in our previous lesson. So in this lesson, we will read the story in detail and talk about the exercises there. Okay, students, are you ready? Then let's start with the first, beginning of the story with some pictures, and we will go into the story and the exercises. Okay, let's get started with the pictures here first. The first picture you can see in your book is this man. Can you describe this picture, students? All right. Who is this person and what is he doing? Can you remember the story? And what is he holding in his hand? Yes, the man is, what is the name of the man? Yes, Chulong is the name of the man, and he is holding a bird. And what is the color of the bird? It's colorful, okay? It has different colors, so it is colorful. And where is the man? The man is in his garden. And what is the name of the story? Once again, can you remember? Yes, that's very good. It's three simple rules. Okay, we will find out once again what are those three simple rules. And we will also find out the whole story and the exercises. Now, let me show you some pictures to understand or to remember the story. Okay, students, let's see the pictures. Now you are supposed to arrange these pictures into orders, into an order, into an order, and then make the story. Can you now find out which is the beginning of the story and then what comes next? Okay, students, so you have an angry man, a beautiful bird, a sad man, a greedy man maybe, and a bird, beautiful bird, a black bird. Okay, what happens in the beginning? First, there is a beautiful bird, right? And then where is it going? It is going to the man's garden. And what does the man do? He wants to catch that bird and sell it to the market and earn more money, right? Yes, so we can arrange this picture into this order. So you might have guessed it correctly. So the first is this beautiful bird, okay? And then comes to the greedy man with money and wanting more money. And then there is a black bird. What makes the bird black? When the man catches the bird, it turns into a black bird. And then the man is very angry, right? The man is so angry that he wants to kill the bird and eat the bird because he could not earn money by selling the beautiful bird. So then the bird tells him that the bird will give some simple rules which will benefit the man, and then the man lets the bird go free, and then it sits on a tree, and then he tells the three simple rules, but the rules were already known to all. So the man again gets angry, and then the bird says that you didn't follow the simple rule, though you knew the rule, okay, already knew the rule, but you didn't follow the rule. So it is very important to follow the rule. If you followed the rule, you would not miss me or lose me. So this is how the story ends, the man regretting at the end. Okay, now I have these the sentences from the pictures. Now we are going to arrange the these sentences to create the story. Okay, students, so first we have the man was angry, the bird reminded him that he didn't follow the rules, and in return, she would give him three simple rules. So which one do you think is the first one? Okay, so we should look for and look at the picture as well, we should look for the bird, which is very beautiful. So first, there is the description of the beautiful bird. Okay, here is the description here. Can you read it aloud? Yes, there was a beautiful bird in a man's garden. So we put it at the beginning of the story. And then what happens after that? The man wants to get money from it, right? So where is the sentence here? Yes, it's here. The man wanted to sell the bird and earn money. So we will put it next to this sentence. Okay, so the man wanted to sell the bird and earn money. Now after that, look at the picture. What is happening there? The bird changes its color into black, into blackbird. So blackbird is not beautiful bird, so nobody can buy it. Then what happens? The man gets very, very angry towards the bird, right? And then next picture is the bird suggesting, okay? So the bird suggests the man as to let the bird free, okay? So the bird suggests the man, angry man, to let him free, let her free. So in return, what happens? She will give three simple rules which will benefit him, okay? And the rules were simple. The rules were simple and everybody knew that rules. So the man was again very angry towards the bird because it was already known to all. So he got angry and again said, this is very simple rule and everybody knows it. You have cheated me. Okay, then bird says that this is simple rule, but you didn't follow the rules. The bird reminded him that he didn't follow the rules, though it was very simple. So that was the mistake. And the bird flew away. And finally, the man was sad to lose the bird. Okay, this is the story, students, about these three simple rules. Okay, we will find out those three simple rules in the text. Now we will go into the text. Let's go into the text. Before that, let's have a look at the words in detail. So we see words like strange, unseen, imprisonment, shattered, irritated, released, silly, and disappeared. Okay, the meanings of these words are, first, unfamiliar, not seen before, and unseen means not seen, imprisonment means be in a case, shattered means broken or damaged or destroyed, irritated means angry or annoyed, released means set free, silly means foolish or showing no sense, and disappeared means lost or not in the sight. Okay, so once again, here in the story, what is a strange? Can you remember? Yes. The strange thing in the story was the bird, because the man didn't see the bird before. It was unfamiliar. Unfamiliar means he didn't see it before, not seen before. So unseen. What is unseen here, not seen here? The man, when he wanted to cast the bird, he tried to become unseen and cast the bird. Okay, students, now next one is imprisonment. What was imprisoned? Imprisonment means be in a cage or kept in a cage. So here, the bird was imprisoned, or the bird was in imprisonment. Means the man kept the bird in a cage, in an enclosure. Okay, students? So, imprisonment means keeping in a cage. Shattered Shattered means broken, damaged, destroyed. What was shattered in the story? The man's dream was shattered. Okay? It was broken. Why? Because of the changed color of the beautiful bird. Okay, and another one is irritated. Irritated means annoyed or angry. Who was irritated in the story? The man was irritated. Why? Because the bird, you know, said the simple rules which was known to all. Another one is released. Released means set free. Finally, what was released? The bird was released free. And the bird, you know, flew away. So set free means to give or let the bird go away. Another one is silly. Silly means foolish or showing no sense. And the man was silly or didn't show the sense, no sense. Another one is disappeared. Disappeared means lost. The bird finally lost in the jungle because it flew away from the man. Okay, now let's go into the story in detail with the questions and the vocabularies in the discussion here. So let me ask you some questions before. Where is the man? What is he holding in his hand? And what is his name? Let's find out here, okay? So once there was a rich man in a village. Okay? Let's find out who was he. His name was Cholong. Despite being rich, he still wanted more riches, more money. Okay, can you now see the name? Who is the person? What is the name? Cholong. Where is it? Yes, it's here. Cholong was the name of the man. Now another question we have to find is, what is he holding in his hand? Let's look at the answer here. One day he was walking in his garden. He saw a strange bird in a bush. It was very small, but it had very beautiful and colorful feathers. Its voice was also very sweet. Okay, so here he sees the bird, and he is now holding a bird in his hand. Okay, students. Now, where is the man? The man is in his garden. Where is the answer here? Yes, it's here. The man is in the garden. Now, we have seen some new words which we discussed in the previous slide. Riches. What is the meaning of riches here? Let's see. He still wanted more riches. He still wanted more riches means he wanted more money or wealth. Okay, students? And he saw a strange bird. Strange here means the bird which was not seen here. Okay? Which was not seen by the man before. And what did the man find in his garden? He found a beautiful and colorful bird in his garden. Okay, now let's go to the next paragraphs of the story. Here, Cholong had never seen such a bird in his life, and he slowly went near the bush unseen. Unseen, we talked about it. Unseen means not being visible. And he caught the bird, and the bird spoke, "Why have you caught me? Why have you caught me?" So, "I want to make money. I can sell you for a big amount." So you look at here, amount is the new word here. So big amount means the sum of money, a total of the money that he wants to earn. Okay, amount means that thing. So his, the bird says, "But you are already rich. Why do you want more?" The bird said, "You are already rich. You have already enough money. So why do you want more?" Then he said, "Because I want to become richer and richer." Okay, "I want to become richer and richer," Cholong replied, "but do not dream of making money through me." So the bird reminded him not to earn money from the bird, said the bird, and it further added, "You cannot sell me. You cannot sell me. Nobody will buy me because in imprisonment." We talked about this word, imprisonment. Means the bird was caught. Okay, in imprisonment, the bird is kept inside a cage, or it is bound with strings, and "I will lose my beauty and my sweet voice. What happens when imprisonment? There is a condition when the bird is imprisoned or in imprisonment, it loses its beauty and sweet voice. Okay, so that the man won't be able to earn money by selling the bird, because the bird turns into black or ugly and nobody will buy that. So that was said by the bird. The bird slowly now turned into a blackbird. The beautiful feathers now looked like the feathers of a crow. What is the color of crow? Okay, a crow is black and not so beautiful, not so colorful. So Tsulung's hope, when the bird changed into blackbird, hopes of making money were shattered. Okay, shattered here means destroyed, the dream destroyed, or damaged, okay, or broken into pieces, we can call it shattered. So his hope for making money was now no more possible because of the lost beauty. Now let's answer the questions. What did the man want from the bird? What did the man want? Yes, he wanted to make money. He wanted to become rich, or he wanted more riches from the bird. And how was his dream shattered? Okay, how was the dream shattered? How was the dream destroyed? Because in imprisonment, the bird changed its color into black, so his dream of making money was shattered. Okay, now let's look at the next paragraph. Here, he said angrily, now he became angry, okay, as we said earlier, when the bird changed its color, he said, I will kill you and I'll eat your meat. Okay, then what happened? What did the bird say? Let's see. The bird said, eat me, I'm so small, you will not get enough meat to kill your hunger. You cannot, fulfill your hunger with my meat. So the bird replied, and Tsulung could not answer anything. The bird suggested that, well, set me free. In return, I shall teach you three simple but useful rules. The bird said that I will give you three simple rules which are very important and that will benefit you. That is very important if you follow that. And by listening to it, the man says, what is the use of the rules? I want only money. Okay, I want money, not the rules, he said. And he was irritated now. The man was irritated, but these rules can profit you greatly, said the bird. I read the bird. But again said, you will be in profit. So the man was very greedy and said, profit me? Oh, I'll get profit? Really? Then I shall set you free, so you can be free. But how can I trust you? You may fly away, said Tsulung. So he didn't trust, or he didn't believe him. So we can see here, it irritated. We talked about its meaning. Irritated means annoyed or angry. And here, the bird said, I give you my word, I promise, and I always keep my word, said the bird. Tsulung wanted to take a chance, and so he released the bird. Released here means freed, or said the bird, free, and it flew up at once, quickly it flew up. And then it sat on the branch of a tree. Its color started changing now, and it became beautiful again. The bird became, when once it was released, the bird changed and it became beautiful, colorful, and in different colors, and its feathers were looking very beautiful. And what happened now? Let's look at, first let's see the question. What did the bird suggest to the man? What was the suggestion by the bird to get the money or to get the profit? The suggestion was that to set the bird free, set me free, and in return, the bird would teach three simple but useful rules. Okay, then where did the bird go? After, you know, the man set him free, where did it go? It went to, let's find out where it went. Yes, it flew, you know, flew away. So, and it sat, you know, look at here, it sat on a branch of a tree. So it means bird went to a tree. Okay, students, now we have the final part of the story. What happens next? Let's find out here. Chulong then asked, "Now teach me the rules. Now teach me the rules which you said that would profit me. I want the profit." Then bird said, "Certainly, I'll tell you certainly." Then bird said, "The first rule, let's see here, the rules are given here. Never believe everything others say." The first one, never believe everything others say. The second rule is never be sad about something you do not have. And the third rule is never throw away what you have in your hand. These were the three rules. Now, the man shouted. Why he shouted? Let's see. "You silly bird," shouted Sal. "These three rules are known to everyone. Everyone knows this rule. You have cheated me. You said I will be profited by the rules, and the rules were very useful, but you said very simple rules." The bird said, now, finally, what the bird said, now let's see. "Chulong, sit down and just listen for a while. Sit down for a while. Think about all your actions. Think about all your actions of today. You had me in your hands, but you released me. You believed all that I said, and you are sad about not having me. The real rules are simple, but you never followed them." Okay? You said the rules are known and simple, but you never followed them. "Now, do you see the values of the rules?" The bird said that the three rules were not to let the things you have, but you released me. And the rule said not to believe everyone or everything, but you believed all that I said. And another rule was that not to worry or be sad when you don't have something, but you are sad not having me. So the rules are simple, but you didn't follow that. Now, do you remember or do you see the value of following rules? Then the bird flew away and disappeared from his sight. Okay, so here, silly bird, the man said that you have no sense, silly means, and disappeared here means lost or not in the sight. So questions here, now to you, what were the three rules? Can you see the three rules here in this space? Where is it? Yes, you can see here the first rule, yes, and the second rule, and third rule, okay? So never believing others, whatever they say, and second is never be sad about something you do not have, and the third rule is never throw away what you have in your hand, okay? What you have got, never throw away or neglect or do not lose. Okay, students, so these were the three simple rules that were taught by the bird to the man, and that was already known, but it was reminded that to follow rule is very important or profitable. Okay, now we have talked about the whole story. Now we are going to talk about the exercises given in our book. Okay, students, now let's see. Notice the use of the following words in the story and make sensible sentences of your own. Now you have to look at the words again. We have already talked about it, though. We can say, let's see, rich is, where is it? You can see here, yes, it's here. Despite being rich, he still wanted more riches. Now you know that what is it, what it means. Riches means wealth. Now, and again, another word is feathers. What is feathers? Can you see here feathers anywhere, somewhere here? Yes, it's here, down here. But it had very beautiful and colorful feathers. Okay, what does a bird have that is colorful and beautiful? Okay, certainly birds birds have feathers. So feathers means the outer part of the bird which you can see and which by which they fly. Okay, students? So next word is amount. What is the meaning of amount? Let's see here. What is amount here? It's here. I can sell you for a big amount. Big amount means the, you know, collection, collective, or the total size or quantity of something. So money is here. Now we have another word, dream. What is the meaning of dream? Do you see dream? Dreams are two kinds of dreams. One dream is that you see while you are asleep or while you are sleeping. Another type of dream is that what you wished or what you want to be, what you want to get, that is your dream. Okay? So here the man, but do not dream of making money through me, the bird has said, or do not plan for that, or do not wish for that. Another is believe. What is the meaning of believe here? Let's see here. Here is the word believe. You believed all that I said. Believe means agreeing someone, what someone says, okay? Or following someone, what someone says. So believing means following someone or agreeing or trusting. Okay, now the final word is follow. What is to follow? Let's find out the word first. Where is the follow? Can you see here in the on the screen? Follow. You can see here. Never feeling okay. Yes, here. But you never followed them. You never followed the rules. Following rules means, okay, doing the rules or applying the rules. Okay. So you don't go against the rule. Following means you accept the rules and then you move according to the rules. Okay. So follow means to do or act upon the rules. Okay, now we found that the sentences were like, yes, he still wanted more riches, more money, but it had very beautiful and colorful feathers. And I can sell you for a big amount, but do not dream of making money. You believe that all that I said, but you never followed them. Now, these are the sentences from our book. You can make your own sentences. How can you make your own sentences? Okay, I'll give you some examples here. Look at this sentence here. What I have written here? Okay, many people dream to have riches. You can say riches means wealth. So you can say many people dream to have riches. Okay, students? So riches means to have wealth or money. Okay, students? So you can make your own sentence like this. Another sentence, another word was feathers, is feathers. So how can you use in your sentence? I have one example. Birds can fly using their feathers. Okay, how can birds fly? By using their feathers. Okay, if they don't have feathers, they cannot fly. So you can use like this, or you can simply say, I like the colorful feathers of birds. You can make such sentences in your own word. Amount, another word we have is amount. You can say, I have a small amount of money now. It means that you don't have much money now. You have less amount of money. It means the sum of money or the quantity of the money is less. Okay, these are some examples I have done for you. You can do by yourself for the rest of the words. As I said, dream means there are two kinds of dreams, and you see dreams at night or you see dreams every day that you want to be something or you wish to have something. Believe that you follow someone, agree someone, whichever, you know, whatever someone says, you follow them, then you are believing. And follow means following rules. You can follow someone's guidance. If someone tells you to do something, you are following that person. Okay, you can use these words in your own words, as the question says to you. Okay, students, this is the first exercise from our book. Now let's have a look at the next sentence. That is, read the text again and write true or false. Now we are very sure about the whole story. What is happening there, what happened there, And now we know everything. Let's decide which sentences are true and which are false. Okay, let me read it aloud to you. Chulong was satisfied with his riches. Do you agree with this? Was he satisfied? Satisfied means he was happy. Okay, satisfied, to become satisfied means to become happy. Was he happy with whatever he had or with the money he had? No, right? He was not happy. He wanted to get money by selling the pot again. Even if he had already more money, he wanted more, means he was not happy. Now, next sentence is, he bought a bird to keep at home. Did he bought the bird? No, he didn't bought. He didn't want to keep it at his home. And another sentence is, his greed set the bird free. Okay, greed means things that somebody wants too much. Okay, so he wanted to have more money. So that is his greed. And because of that, he set the bird free. Is it right? I think so. Okay, I will show you the answer later. The bird cheated Chulong. Did the bird cheated Chulong? Do you think the bird cheated? As he said, you cheated me. Did the bird cheat it? I don't think so. The bird didn't cheat, right? Because the bird said that I'll tell you three simple rules, and the bird said the three simple rules. Only the man didn't follow it. That was the problem. Okay, the last one is, the bird changed its color twice. It's true. Now let's see. The first one is false, and the second one is false. He didn't want to keep at home. And a man was greedy, yes. And the bird cheated, it's false. The bird changed its color twice, yes. First it became black, and then it became again colorful. So it's true. Okay, students. Now let's have a look at our another exercise. Answer the following questions from exercise C. The questions are, what was the main aim of Chulong? Okay, now answer is simple to you because we have already known the story. Second question is, why could Chulong not make money from the bird? What were the three simple rules the bird told Chulong? And what type of person is Chulong? And the final question is, what lesson did you learn from the story? Okay, now let's answer the first one. We have already known that the aim of Chulong was to get money, become very rich, right? The aim of Chulong was to become a very rich man, right? Yes, and second is, why could Chulong not make money from the bird? What was the reason he couldn't be successful? Because in imprisonment, the bird lost her beauty and her sweet voice. When he kept inside the imprisonment, the bird was not beautiful. So he couldn't make money. And what were the three simple rules the bird told Chulong? Okay, I'll tell you here in short. You can make it longer. Never believe everything whatever others say. And never be sad about what you don't have. Another one is, never throw away what you have in your hand. These are the three simple rules told by the birds. Okay, students, you find it very clearly now. What type of person is Chulong? What do you think about this person? Okay, you can say he was a greedy and selfish person. And what lesson did you learn from the story? You learned that we should be wise but not greedy. We should follow the rules. Okay, these are the lessons we get from the story. Now we have this last exercise that, imagine that you were Chulong, what would you do when the colorful bird turned into a black bird, a black crow? Write in a few lines. Okay, students, suppose you cut a colorful bird like the man and the bird changed its color. Now, what would you do? Now, let's share our, thinking what we would do. And maybe this was the beautiful bird you cut and it changed into this colorless bird. You may say, If I were too long, I would, you have to follow this structure, okay, students? If I were too long, comma, I would, you have to now complete the sentences with different ideas. Okay, I'll give you different options. You can write, release the bird. You can say, I would release or I would free the bird. You can say, ask how I can change her or how I can help her to become beautiful. Another one is, I would make her happy. I would not say that I will sell you. And I would give delicious food to make her happy. I would request the bird to show her beauty. I would be polite to the bird. Or I would say I wouldn't sell her. These are the possible answers you can make by yourself. Okay, you have to complete the sentence with these possible answers. Okay, students? Okay, now we have come to the last ending of this lesson. We read the story. We talked about the different characters like the man Sulong and the bird, and there was the plot of catching the bird and trying to sell the bird. And we had the setting of the garden, and then there was the moral or the theme of the story that we should not neglect the simple rules, and we should not be unkind to the other creatures. And vocabularies we learned is strange, unseen, imprisonment, shattered, irritated, released, silly, disappeared, reaches, feathers, amount, dream, believe, and follow. Well, students, this is the homework for you. You can write short, summary of the story with the characters, and what happened there, and where was it, and what is the lesson. And then you can apply these words in your own sentences. This is the task for you. So this is the end of our today's lesson. Thank you all for joining this lesson. We will see in our next video lesson. Thank you so much. See you. Namaste.